On this week's show, we hear some convincing rumours about Nissan's next generation LEAF, Audi puts plug-in cars at the heart of its future market plans, and a teenager offers a Tesla-themed alternative to air travel. These stories and more coming up next on 10. Enjoying today's show on YouTube and want to read the stories you're referring to today? Just head to our website at transportevolved.com/TEN, where you'll find today's show notes, as well as links to the latest future car news, buying guides, tech primers, and car reviews. It's Friday, November 20th, 2015. I'm Nikki Gordon-Bloomfield, and I'd like to thank all 46 patrons who are pledging to bring you this show ad-free every week. Want to join them? You can donate from as little as $1 a month over at patreon.com/transportevolved. Prompted in part by Nissan's recent tours of its Japanese Technical Engineering Center ahead of the recent Tokyo Motor Show, we spent some time this week collating some new rumors about what to expect of Nissan's next generation LEAF electric car. As we explained on Monday, while Nissan isn't even yet acknowledging the next generation LEAF will exist, the recent Technical Engineering Center visit and subsequent press releases from Nissan showcased a new 60 kilowatt hour lithium ion battery pack, the same physical size as the new 30 kilowatt hour battery pack found in the new 2016 Nissan LEAF, as well as a fairly advanced 7 kilowatt wireless inductive charging system. Tie that in with Nissan's work on improved aerodynamics, autonomous driving technology, and some pretty big hints dropped by Nissan engineers during the tour, and several outlets are predicting that the next generation LEAF will include all of the above, boasting a 300 plus mile per charge range to boot. Sadly, Nissan isn't officially confirming it, but head to our site to read up on the rumors and judge their plausibility for yourself. First unveiled less than a year ago as a concept car at the Detroit Auto Show, the Chevrolet Bolt EV is GM's first truly long-range electric car and is expected to hit dealer lots this time next year, with a price tag of around $35,000 after incentives and a range of about 200 miles per charge. So far, we've only seen engineering prototypes of the Bolt EV and the original Detroit Auto Show concept car. But come January 7th, we'll get to see the production version of the Bolt EV for the first time at the 2016 Consumer Electronics Show in Las Vegas, Nevada. And that's according to GM's Vice President Mark Ross, who made the announcement at this week's LA Auto Show. Sadly, he didn't go into details as to what we can expect, but based on what we know thus far, we're guessing that the production Bolt EV will likely lose the panoramic glass roof of the concept car, plus perhaps a few of the futuristic interior items in preference to something a little more hard-wearing and practical. As for the rest, well, we'll just have to wait till January to find out. After a fairly long wait, the 2016 Hyundai Sonata plug-in hybrid went on sale this week in selected markets in the US, priced from $34,600 before incentives. Powered by a 9.8 kilowatt hour lithium-ion battery, 50 kilowatt motor, and 2-liter petrol engine, this South Korean sedan offers an all-electric range of around 27 miles per charge, placing it ahead of other plug-in hybrids like the Ford Fusion, or Mondeo plug-in hybrid, and the Toyota Prius plug-in hybrid in terms of all-electric capabilities. Its arrival in the US market means that customers can now choose between it and conventional gasoline, hybrid, or plug-in hybrid models, and heralds the arrival of a similar lineup choice in the Kia Optima, starting next year in Europe and the US. But at that kind of price and performance, only 40 miles per gallon when the battery is flat, we're thinking most buyers will opt for the range-extended Chevrolet Volt, if they happen to live in a market where it's available, that is. Do you like the look of this new car, or does it leave you feeling somewhat meh? Leave your thoughts in the comments below. Making its first appearance in the US, the Honda Clarity fuel cell sedan landed in Los Angeles this week, with the news that it would be available to buy in selected Californian markets as of late 2016, with a planned rollout and expansion over the next 4 years or so. No news on Europe, I'm afraid. Sorry. But what's really interesting here isn't the Clarity. It's the news that Honda plans to launch a plug-in hybrid based on the Clarity FCV sometime in 2018, which it says will offer a 40-mile electric range. While Honda once maintained hydrogen was the only way to go, it seems the automaker now wants to offer a range of vehicles, ranging from full electrics to plug-in hybrids and fuel cell vehicles. Has Honda realized it was a fuel cell folly it was previously unaware of, or does it want to let customers pick the best fuel for their own use? We're not sure either is true, but we are supportive of its new and far more welcoming attitude to future drivetrain technology. Tesla's first Gigafactory might not even be finished yet, but we're already starting to hear rumors about places where we might see Tesla build future Gigafactories. And this week, one such rumor came from a seemingly trustworthy source, the German government. As we explained earlier this week, Germany's economy minister Sigmar Gabriel told Bloomberg that Tesla Motors has been in discussion with the German government about the possibility of building Gigafactory number 2 in Germany. But, as we say back in my home county of Norfolk, hold you hard, boar. You see, while Sigmar was upbeat about Gigafactory possibilities in Germany, Tesla itself denies that it has any current plans to build a battery factory anywhere in Germany. Does this mean the rumour is no good? Not at all. Note the careful use of the word current. We think that says all there is to know about this one for now. The 2015-2016 FIA Formula E season may have already begun, but this week we learn that the city of Mexico will play host to the fifth round, filling the large gap between Buenos Aires on February 6th and Long Beach, USA on April 2nd. Having attended last year's finals in London, I can tell you it's well worth visiting, and here's hoping that round 5 in Mexico City on March 12th is as fun and exciting as the first two rounds of the season, which have already taken place in China and Malaysia. Tickets, we guess, will go on sale soon, so if you're planning a holiday to Mexico in March or already live there, be sure to nab some tickets. How much things can change in a week. This time last week, while telling you that Audi had plans to bring its e-tron Quattro to market, I remained sceptical that the 300-mile plug-in car would make it to market in any significant volumes. This week, I'm more convinced, however, thanks to news from the Los Angeles Auto Show that Audi is pushing to have between one-fifth and one-quarter of all cars it sells in 2025 complete with a plug. Leading that drive will be the all-new Audi e-tron Quattro SUV, which still has to get its official name, plus the Audi A3 e-tron plug-in hybrid, which, while already available in Europe, goes on sale in the US this fall. As for other models, well, we're guessing the R8 e-tron Quattro will take care of Audi's sports car segment, but we're already predicting a high-end luxury electric sedan, similar to one of Audi's previous e-tron Quattro concept cars, as well as perhaps an all-electric A3 or similarly sized hatchback, capable of around 300 miles per charge. We should reiterate that that last part was pure speculation, but in order to sell cars, that many cars, in just 10 years' time, we think Audi will need to do something like that to make its goal come true. Like its fellow German automaker Audi, BMW has been busy at the LA Auto Show this week, displaying not only the production BMW X5 xDrive 40e, but also previewing the BMW 330e plug-in hybrid 3 Series, which is due to enter production and market next year. It's also taken out time to announce the expansion of its Charge Now program across the US, offering BMW i3 owners who purchased their electric car after November 1st this year the chance to charge their car for free using CCS quick charging stations owned and operated by NRG EVgo for the next 2 years. The problem? The scheme doesn't include BMW i3 owners who purchased their car before November 1st this year, leaving some BMW customers very, very unhappy indeed. To be fair to BMW, Nissan has the same policy regarding its own free charging, no charge to charge program. But perhaps it's time for automakers to just help out those early adopters a little bit more. What do you think? The tiny Renault Twizy Urban Runabout is one fun little vehicle to explore any busy megacity. But this week we brought you news from Japan, where the Renault Twizy's twin, the Nissan Mobility Concept EV, has just celebrated 2 years of service, providing transport to tourists in the rural areas surrounding Kobe, Japan. Known as the EV Mountain Project, the tiny two-seat runabouts have helped holidaymakers get up close and personal with the local wildlife without worrying about spewing out nasty pollutants, while of course handling those tight mountain roads with ease. You can read more about the program at our website, as well as hear about how Kobe plans to expand the program into its inner city areas too, making it one a very friendly place to own and operate an electric car. For as long as we can remember, anyone owning an electric car has needed a fistful of different smart cards and key fobs to give them easy access to the many different charging networks that are out there. In Europe, we've been able to enjoy some cross-compatibility for quite some time, depending a little on where you live in Europe and who your regular provider is. But on Thursday at the LA Auto Show, three of America's biggest charging providers, NRG EVgo, ChargePoint and Blink announced the founding of ROEV, a vehicle charging association which will make it easier for people to charge their cars at different charging stations using just one charging account. Essentially a roaming agreement, much like you find on cash machines or mobile phones, this new organisation should put pay to the pain of not having the right charging card at the right time. But given how tough it's been for the charging industry to play nicely with one another thus far, we're going to wait a while before declaring that particular problem solved for good, especially considering some of the reliability problems quite a few charging networks still seem to be plagued by. And finally, even if, like me, you enjoy the experience of flying, the chances are you hate the experience of getting on the plane, from the being at the airport super early to doing battle with queues and security, finding overpriced refreshments at the check-in gate, and, of course, those horrible and inevitable flight delays. Well, this week we told you about a new alternative called Tesloop, an innovative and fun alternative to those who want to travel from Los Angeles to Las Vegas. Founded by a 16-year-old this summer, Tesloop offers to drive you and your friends between the two cities for just $85 each, can carry more luggage than your average budget airline will, and doesn't come with any of those nasty check-in queues. Plus, of course, it's far more environmentally friendly, and you get to ride in a Tesla too. Check out the coverage of this new service at our website and let us know if you'd consider it an alternative to flying if the service was offered in your neck of the woods. That's your lot for today, and in fact your lot for 2 weeks. That's because the US has Thanksgiving next week, and like REI, we're going to spend it outside. So if you're celebrating, have an extra slice of pumpkin pie for us. In the meantime, you'll find all the news that's fit to print at our website at transportevolve.com. Catch up with us on Twitter at transportevolve, or check out our latest shows on our usual YouTube channel. And if you liked what you saw today, consider keeping us independent and impartial by visiting our Patreon page at patreon.com/transportevolved and pledging your support from as little as $1 per month. If everyone who watched this video made that pledge, it'd not only fund some great new shows, but allow us to expand our staff too. So go on, help us out. As always, there's a lot we haven't managed to fit into today's show, including Volvo's vision of what the inside of an autonomous car could be like in the future. Reader Rides contributor Stephen Nocter explains why we need more DC quick charging. Kia unveils a massive investment in plug-in, self-driving and fuel cell technology. And we say goodbye to our Mitsubishi i-MiEV staff car. So when we're done, be sure to head to our site to read them all. Thanks for watching. I'm Nikki Gordon-Bloomfield. Have a great weekend, and until 2 weeks' time, keep evolving.